for the Citadel, struggling a little bit, but it's going to be a good night of competition here at McAllister.
We look toward UNCG's Francis Alonso. He's one of the best guards to ever play in the program.
Francis Alonso, just one of the better players in the Southern Conference. The Spain native kind of does it all for the Spartans. He's a gutsy player. He can really get the ball in and out. He makes defenses crash inside, and then that provides threats on the outside for the Spartans.
And for the Citadel, the old conference knows about Lou Stallworth. What can we expect to see from him tonight?
Lou Stallworth, just all the same. He's done it all year long. It's his final season of college basketball. He's playing with heart and with grit. He's the leader for this Bulldog team. He's going to go out with a bang.
It's the Bulldogs and the Spartans, and the opening tip is right after this.
You are capable of more than you think. It's not easy, but you make it together. What you learn goes beyond the classroom. By learning how to follow, you discover the kind of leader you want to be. It's about discipline, detail, hard work, and serving others. Choose something different, and you'll never be the same.
And we're back inside of McAllister Fieldhouse in Charleston, South Carolina. The Citadel and UNCG getting set to do battle. The final home game for the Citadel Bulldogs in the regular season before these two teams head to Asheville next week. It's tournament time and March one day away. There's the UNCG starting five. We told you about Francis Alonso. You got to pay attention to Demetrius Troy as well, another senior guard that doesn't make a lot of mistakes. And this is a UNCG team that represented the SoCon a season ago in the NCAA tournament. They are for real. 24 wins on the year. And there's Lou Stallworth. We told you about him in the open as well, as really thrived in Duggar Baulkham's system. And this lineup has changed a handful of times over the course of the season. And Duggar Baulkham going back with the grad transfer Connor Kern reinserted in the lineup tonight as well.
Yeah, Connor Kern trying to stay consistent. He shot it well this past weekend against Samford, and he's still a threat on that dribble drive. He protects the paint very well. He's a good defender up top in their 3-2 zone. It's going to be a switch that Coach Baulkham wanted to make, and going to stay strong with the grad transfer there.
There's Wes Miller, eighth season, North Carolina, 2007 grads. Went from walk-on to being one of the better players for the Tar Heels by his senior season. He's done a really nice job with this program. Again, an NCAA tournament appearance a season ago, and has got this program trending in the right direction, especially when you go back over the last 4 or 5 years. Almost set for the tip here in Charleston. Kendall Lewis and Jansen Brown, we're glad that you are with us here tonight. Citadel looking to gain some momentum. 12 wins on the season. They're 12-15, 4-12 in Southern Conference play. And Duggar Baulkham, the head coach, he's in his fourth season. 95 graduate from UNC Charlotte. Bulldogs want to get it up and down the floor. Biggest thing is, can they make stops tonight against a potent UNCG offense who has plenty of shooters and plenty of weapons?
Yeah, I think the Citadel defense steps up like they did closing out on Samford. As you see here, like I was just mentioning, moving on defense is going to be vital for the Citadel. Have to keep on their toes and crash the boards. Don't allow UNCG to get those second chance points. UNCG just needs to do what they've been doing all season to get to that 24-5 record that they're boasting at the moment.
Zainaj Dawi will jump it up against Kyron Galloway for the Spartans of UNCG. And here we go from Charleston, South Carolina. And the Spartans control the opening tip. Quickly, they get it to the senior leader, Demetrius Troy. Doesn't make a lot of mistakes. Fourth in the Southern Conference in assist to turnover ratio. Alonso, he'll let it fly off the start, and he could knock it down. Bulldogs want to get it up and down the floor. Stallworth gets into the paint. He's so good when he can get in the paint and kick out. Hayden Brown will dish it away, and the Bulldogs instead will reset. Shot clock is at 7. Kern swears his feet, and he connects.
Connor Kern's been shooting well this season, coming off of screens like that. He can plant his pivot foot and shoot better. His form looks really well in that motion, shooting instead of a square up. But they're going to have to stay home here on defense against the Spartans.
Inside feed to James Dickey. Miller's been a bit of a surprise this year, and he finds a seam to lay it off the glass.
Speedy Miller went right past Zane Najdawi. When the big man has to come out like that, got to be able to chop your feet, break down in front of a speedy offensive player like that. Make sure he doesn't go by and get down the middle of the lane.
Miller takes it away. He's one of the top defenders in the conference. And that's too easy for the Spartans as they have their first lead here early.
Bulldogs are going to have to be a little bit more careful here. They tend to do a lot of the same things on offense, dribble handoffs, top screens. If they don't change it up a little bit, the speedy defenders of the Spartans are going to be able to jump in front of those, read the system very easily.
13 Southern Conference wins for Wes Miller's crew this season. Here's the feed inside to Zane Najdawi. Backing his way down on Galloway. The turnarounds as the shot clock expires. And Alonzo skies for the rebounds. Foul against Hayden Brown. That's number one of the first half. Just two and change in here in Charleston, South Carolina.
And just an unnecessary foul for Hayden Brown, who's struggled on the year with foul trouble. The ball was already in transition, just reached around. And got one on him there early that might hurt them down the stretch.
And Wes Miller, told you, North Carolina product, part of that North Carolina coaching tree. Demetrius Troy could knock it down from three, and Hamilton pulls down the rebounds, and there's a foul against the Bulldogs. Again, that's number two as a team, and Troy will trigger it in for the Spartans.
See what they look for here. They've been shooting it well in the season. They're going to go to Miller in the backcourt. Wide open in the corner.
And Troy can shoot it in and out, and Miller's there to save the day.
Miller taking the advantage of the undersized Matt Frierson. Didn't turn to find him to box out.
Stallworth, one of the best point guards, arguably the best point guard in the Southern Conference, as Brown connects from deep.
Hayden Brown really proving here throughout the season that he is a threat from deep. He's known as his driving ability. Knocking one down there as Matt Frierson pokes one away. Spartan ball.
This one deflected out of bounds. Active hands on D for the Citadel. And this is a Bulldogs team that will mix it up defensively. We've seen a lot of zone in the half courts. Full court pressure this year. Multiple looks from Duger Balkum. Good cut inside. Hamilton looking for space. And Najdawi's charged with the foul.
Yeah, so the issue here going to the 1-3-1 zone is if Najdawi rotates off to go to ball side, you're going to find Matt Frierson here. Undersized, down low. And Najdawi has to come in and deflect that shot. Getting a foul, that's one for each of the big men on the court now for the Bulldogs.
Eric Hamilton's the transfer from Wichita State. Played in 47 games for the Shockers over those two seasons. A very good rebounder, though. Kind of takes a bit of a load off of James Dickey. Ranks 20th in the Southern Conference, just under 5 rebounds per night. And he goes 1-for-2.
Going to be a tough environment here to play in tonight. A lot of the cadet corps from the Citadel is here sitting behind currently the Bulldog basket.
Stallworth can create his own shot. 6'1", 200 pounds. Big body point guard, especially for the Southern Conference. Frierson, he could shoot it from anywhere on the floor. has the green light in Zuger Balcom's system. Kerr catches, fires, and he hits again.
Another shot there for Connor Kern in motion. He had a fade route. Lou Stallworth hit him in stride, backpedaling just a little bit. Wasn't quite a set shot like I mentioned earlier.
Alonzo from NBA range says, anything you can do, I can do a little bit better.
He's going to come back with a deep shot of his own. Citadel needs to be able to counter and make one more.
Frierson corner pockets, in and out. Good pace to the first half so far. Spartans want to run. Miller absorbs the contact and finishes.
Miller's going to be tough if the Citadel defense doesn't keep him out of the lane. He's a very speedy and snaky guy. Once he gets down low, that's going to get a lot of contact drawn.
Kern again, he's feeling it here in the first half. And Wes Miller wants a timeout. The grad transfer for the Bulldogs knots it up at 12. We'll be right back on ESPN Plus.
The great thing about an old truck is you can treat it like an old truck, which is exactly why you got a truck in the first place. It's not old, it's broken in. So keep it running longer, stronger, with quality parts and a whole lot of Napa know-how. That's not gonna buff out.
TD Bank's new intern, Bart, is one of those robots from another bank. We're training him to bank human. Bart, why are you winding the clock back?
The clock stated 11:35 p.m., but they are still working.
It's fine. Our live customer service is available all night, and all day for that matter. He's learning.
At TD Bank, we do things differently.
Hello?
Like live customer service.
Hello?
24/7. Don't just bank, bank human.
Style. Selection. Service. Quality. Value. See what everyone is talking about. Ashley Furniture Home Store.
One of the more well-known coaches across basketball in general, a guy that has coached at the professional level in the NBA, and also one of the more college-known college coaches as well. The only coach in basketball history to win both an NCAA national championship and an NBA title. He is a mentor of Wes Miller and in attendance tonight in Charleston, South Carolina. How about that? For Wes Miller and this UNCG Spartans crew, you got a Hall of Fame coach here in the building taking in your game.
One of the best to ever do it. 76ers coach, Spurs coach, Clippers coach. He's been all around. He's seen quite a lot of basketball.
Isaiah Miller, sophomore from Covington, Georgia. Alonzo lets it fly. Offensive board right back to him. And the second time is the charm for Alonzo.
Connor Curran's got to get back out in that zone. If Alonzo finds an open look, it's obvious he puts up quantity number of shots.
Stallworth directing traffic. We've seen the Citadel in the first half so far kind of work the shot clock a little deeper than usual. And the teardrop wouldn't go as James Dickey brings it up the floor.
Citadel moves back to their 3-2 defense zone principles.
Alex Reed in the game for the first time tonight. Kendall Lewis and Jansen Brown with you on ESPN Plus. Glad you're tuned in from wherever you may be. Lots of dribble handoffs as Najdawi tries to cut. Active hands. Reed got it back. Kern again. Swirls it in for three.
Four on the night for Connor Kern. The grad transfer having a great start. Putting the Citadel tied at 15 with the Spartans. It's a big start for Connor Kern.
Dickey nowhere to go, trying to face up on Reeds. And there's contact. Foul against Alex Reeds, sophomore from Raleigh, North Carolina.
Connor Curran just hot from deep tonight, hitting four already. Most of his shots have been in motion here. You see the fade, Lou Stallworth finds him on the opposite skip pass. And right here, just right off the floor, broken play. Curran makes the best of it. That's a good shooter in motion.
Quick release. Told you that he is a grad transfer. He's got another year of eligibility as Dickey sticks it in off the inbound. That's too easy for the Spartans.
Yeah, Bulldogs can't allow that to happen. Letting their big guy just stand in the middle. Have to make a little bit more contact than that to get him out. Not let one of those easy ones go down.
This one deflected. Demetrius Troy, active hands on D. Here come the Spartans. A chance to grow this lead. Caleb Hunter's in as well for the Spartans.
Got mentioned earlier, with this zone, Siddall has to stay moving.
Hunter from deep, and an offensive board for Dickey. One of the top rebounders in the SoCon, and Troy knocks it down.
Spartans making the most of second chance opportunities. Bulldogs have got to limit that. That's too many already early on here for the Citadel to have success later in this game.
Both these teams will go deep into their benches. UNCG around 76 points per contest. Citadel 85 and a half. They're in the top 10 in the nation in scoring. They led the nation in scoring through the month of December. And substitutions for both teams as Duggar Balcom goes back to Hayden Brown and Matt Frierson. Just over 12 and a half to play first half. McAllister Fieldhouse from Charleston, South Carolina. This marks the 37th all-time meeting between these two teams. Bouncer out to Reeds, and the corner pockets is money. Good ball game here in the first half. Troy, that's his spot. Can't connect from deep that time.
And that's a good box out by Alex Reed to limit the second chance.
And Stallworth gets downhill to draw the contact.
And that's what happens. Alex Reed set that up in transition by making just a little bit of contact, just enough to get in front of off that long rebound to get in Lou Stallworth in transition, having the ability to still get the ball up close to the rim and finish there. Lou Stallworth has shown all season that he's one of the better finishers at the rim in the Southern Conference.
Arrived at the Citadel by way of UT Rio Grande. He was a guy that had been at two other Division I programs. And the scoring this year has been a bit of a surprise. Was not a biggest scorer at UT Rio Grande or UTEP, but really fits this style. If you ask the coaching staff here in Charleston, they'll tell you he is exactly what they needed to replace Frankie Johnson, who transferred. And goes 1-for-2. We've got a 1-point game with over 12 to play first half.
Bulldogs staying home. They've got to guard that high post there.
Galloway, no can do from the outside.
Jerry Gene Higgins in for Lou Stallworth. He's gotten some quality minutes when Lou's gone out.
This one rejected at the rim. A good block from Hunter. In transition, no, the stick back is good though. And the Spartans are able to clean it up and a 3-point edge.
Just more blue jerseys at the rim than white.
Frierson to tie. This one tapped around, and Alex Reed controls for the Citadel.
Matt Frierson is going to have to hit those tonight to stay competitive here against the Spartans.
Good move, and Frierson, known to be a sniper, Shows he can go off the bounce that time.
A rare 2 points. Doesn't happen often. Collision here at half court.
A little too much. Lawrence the whistle. And that's going to bring us to a break. Over 11 to play. 1 point game here in McAllister Fieldhouse. We'll be back with more SoCon Hoops.
On March 8th,
I got the file on you.
What's it say? Big imagination, plays well with others.
That's what I'm talking about.
Captain Marvel, rated PG-13. Everywhere, March 8th.
MLS is back. It's our soccer. Sunday on ESPN.
World full of same old, lame old burgers? Well, hit reset, because Wendy's made a whole new world with the new Made to Crave menu featuring the peppercorn mushroom melt, barbecue cheeseburger, and the sawsome bacon cheeseburger. Try all three on the new Made to Crave menu today.
They say do what you love, and the rest will take care of itself. At Hyundai, we love building the best SUVs in the industry. Introducing the 2019 North American Utility Vehicle of the Year, the Kona and Kona Electric.
Get four lines of unlimited data for $100 a month at Cricket. Ooh, someone's having a good hair day. Smile, you're on Cricket.
...22-21, good basketball game late in the Southern Conference regular season between UNCG and the Citadel. Kendall Lewis and Jansen Brown here with you. And it's been back and forth. The Citadel, clean looks. Connor Kern, three triples in the first half. That's been a big storyline for the Bulldogs.
Yeah, Bulldogs have looked really well. They've moved the ball well on offense at times. Other times they've allowed UNCG just to step in front of those normal handoffs that they do. They've telegraphed a lot of their passes, but stay competitive in this game so far. If they can limit those second chance opportunities that the Spartans are capitalizing on, it's going to be a close game down the stretch.
Swing this one over to Malik Massey. He's a junior from Charlotte. Wes Miller goes deep into his bench. Massey off the mark. And out of bounds, they say Citadel basketball.
Saw on defense there. Jerry Higgins was isolating Alonzo off ball, not even allowing him to get possession. We'll see how that works out on defense and if they can convert here on the offensive side of the ball.
And this one thrown out of bounds right to our table. So a little miscommunication results in the turnover.
Spartans are doing a great job at forcing Matt Frierson to drive. He had 2 points earlier, one of the few he's made on this season and actually in his career. But when you force him to move and put the ball on the floor, it makes other people become a threat. And if nobody's hitting from deep and Connor Curran can't get the ball as he started hot off this year so far, or this game, excuse me, it's going to be tough for the Bulldogs.
UNCG 50% from the field. The Bulldogs 58%. 7 of 12 shooting here in the first half. It's Dickey. The teardrop is good.
It's going to be a lot of mismatch there when they go into that 3-2. If Connor Kern gets caught in the middle, he's going to be severely undermatched. If they continue to put Dickey at the high post, it's going to be tough. They here go to put sub in Zane Najdawi.
Brown could shoot it from the outside and splashes a three.
And he's 2 for 2 now. Quality shots outside for the Bulldogs.
They dump this one inside. Dickey going to work, and he kisses it off the window. The Bulldogs have had no answer for James Dickey here in the first half.
They sent a late double there. Might have gotten away with a little bit of contact from Hayden Brown coming upside for the double. Not able to shut Dickey down yet.
You'll notice lots of dribble handoffs in the Citadel's offense. Hayden Brown trying to kick it out. Another turnover for the Bulldogs. And a couple times, on the kick, some miscommunication from the Citadel.
And not necessarily a bad thing. It shows that they're getting into the Spartans' defense, just not able to connect with that second pass outside. We'll see if they can make a little bit quicker decisions and communicate a little better on the offensive side of the ball.
Isaiah Miller, he was on the SoCon All-Freshman team a year ago. This UNCG team, they lost a little bit, and an offensive foul away from the basketball. Moving screen against Kyron Galloway.
It's tight. The Spartans run a lot of plays, a lot of movement off ball. Sometimes you can get tied up a little bit there on the baseline, try and get away from your matchup. You see here, putting the big man in the front court of Dickey, long outstretched arms, creating some trouble so far.
Connor Kern surveys the floor. Three made threes here in the first half. Stallworth thought about the three. Nothing inside. Now he'll try it from distance. And it's good.
Bulldogs getting back to their shooting ways. Everybody hitting from deep so far.
Dickey again had this one poked loose. Here comes Stallworth. Trying to get downhill into the paint. Frierson doesn't need a lot of space. The tip back wouldn't drop for Reeds. And Miller controls for the Spartans. He's got an explosive first step.
Good breakdown by Connor Kern. Tough shot.
And missed everything. Rebound off to the Bulldogs. Kern's had the hot hand for the Citadel. And another one.
In motion once again, coming off a little rub of the shoulder, changing direction. Connor Kern catching it in a two-step shot from deep. The Bulldogs looking a little bit more flexible here on offense. Balcom letting them play. Lou Stallworth creating.
Four-point game here in Charleston. We'll be back on ESPN Plus with more Southern Conference basketball.
Buying a home is a big financial decision, so you need a strong team working on your mortgage. That team is at South Atlantic Bank.
Decisions are made right here in our community by mortgage professionals who really know the Lowcountry.
South Atlantic Bank offers competitive rates and terms on loans for home purchase or refinance. If you need a mortgage loan, you need the mortgage loan professionals at South Atlantic Bank.
South Atlantic Bank Mortgage Group, providing the keys to home ownership.
We're married, and as professional golfers, we're very competitive.
But only on the golf course.
72 seconds. How long can you hold your breath?
No competing at home.
Booyah.
That's our rule.
Pure Silk and Barbasol. Proud supporters of professional golf and friendly competition everywhere.
Loser takes out the trash.
Try new Pure Silk and Barbasol razors. Available now nationwide.
Four, thanks to Connor Kern's 12 points in the first half thus far. We've got over 8 minutes to go and a good crowd. The Cadets are in the building here in McAllister Fieldhouse. Final home game for the season. They head to Asheville. UNCG trying to defend their Southern Conference tournament crown. A team that won 27 games a year ago and 25 the year before. They were 27-8 and 15-3 in Southern Conference play. This is a team that had Gonzaga on the ropes in the opening round of the NCAA tournament a season ago. That's a Gonzaga team that returns almost everyone as well. Going to be a contender to win it all again this year. And a foul on the floor with 7:41.
They put Galloway in the middle to go up for those rebounds. It's going to be tough to compete with both Galloway and Dickey's length inside. Those outstretched arms, it's hard to get a rebound unless you put some pressure on them first, make contact, try to scoot them out of the lane.
Derek Webster Jr. will check in for Zane Najdawi. Got to give Najdawi a breather from time to time here in this one. He's got two fouls as well. No sense in playing with fire for Duggar Balcom. Extra pass to Miller. Drops it off to Dickey.
It's going to be tough there on the far side if the zone isn't rotating fast enough.
And another turnover back to UNCG. So the door is open. The Spartans can tie or take the lead here. Citadel's played a solid first half of basketball so far, but Jansen, there has been three possessions off the top that have been miscommunication of some sort.
Yeah, and here's a deep pass thrown out of bounds by Troy. Gets the Citadel yet another chance, but I think the key so far is, although they're shooting well, it's actually not their main shooter. So Matt Fireson is 0-for-3 on the game. But what that does is, with Lou Stallworth making one, Hayden Brown making two, Connor Kern hitting five, and Alex Reed with one, that creates more threats outside and more guys for the Spartans to worry about on defense than the original scouting report. So it's going to be an interesting shift here to see what the Spartans do.
Good ball movement for the Bulldogs. Stallworth trying to attack the cup. Had this one ripped away by Isaiah Miller. In transition are the Spartans. Massey for three, and he hits. The Spartans retake the lead here in Charleston with under seven to play.
Lou Stallworth has gotten inside deep in the lane quite a few times over the last couple games and gotten it stripped away. It's tough when the defensive connects. Hayden Brown wide open underneath.
And he gets it to go. Bit of a scare there. And a defensive breakdown if you're Wes Miller's unit. Totally lost Hayden Brown there.
And those are the type of opportunities that Citadel has got to take advantage.
All the time in the world for Miller. And he still couldn't hit, but off of Kern, it will stay on this end. There's Connor Kern from Pickerington, Ohio. Grad transfer, played at Arkansas State a season ago. He told you he's got one more year of eligibility. Guys like Connor Kern and Hayden Brown. Alex Reed going to carry a lot of the loads for this Bulldogs team in the coming year. Allegri, he knocks it down.
That's tough. Lou Stallworth had the assignment, the defensive assignment, up top on key. Allegri had the ball. Lou Stallworth left for an open shot.
And right on cue is Frierson. Back and forth we go here in Charleston.
It's going to be Matt Frierson's first. If they can get a lot of these guys hot from deep, it's going to put an interesting spin on the game.
Allegri again. Way off the mark that time. Stallworth, a good facilitator when he's not scoring. And Brown was fouled. Angelo Allegri, he's a freshman for Wes Miller's crew. Long body, 6'7", 205. He's a guy that can play inside and out, but defensively brings a lot to this Spartans unit. Can alter some shots off of smaller guards in this league. Shot clock is at 7. Stallworth calls for it. Here he is from NBA range and off the heel.
Little pull up there. Two Bulldogs leave the ball.
And Massey makes him pay.
Just miscommunication there again. Leaving the man with the ball. Send two to go to the wing. One man didn't stay home. Spartans convert.
Kern catches and fires. And he's still hot.
From deep, Connor Kern taking two or three steps back from his normal range. Connor Kern 6 for 6 now from downtown.
Best first half performance for Kern this season.
Got Alonzo in the corner.
And he'll make you pay. Does again. Doesn't need a lot of space. And when he gets those toes down, can be deadly. One of the best shooters in the Southern Conference. And that's not just this season. That's going back the last several seasons. Since he arrived at UNCG, has made an impact. And Frierson loves the corner. He does it again.
Bulldogs shooting well. They haven't done that quite this season.
And a travel against Francis Alonzo. We'll take a timeout. 3:45 to play in the first half. It's a 1-point Citadel lead on ESPN Plus.
On March 8th.
A rough day, Agent Fury.
You know, typical 9-to-5.
Witness the rise of a hero.
That's what I'm talking about.
Captain Marvel, rated PG-13.
The Greek Freak takes on King James in LA tonight on ESPN.
MLS is back. It's our soccer. Sunday on ESPN.
You're gonna make me turn back, way back to the oldest me. Guarantee that you notice me. You don't walk on my soul from sleep. You're gonna make me turn back, way back to the oldest me. Guarantee that you notice me.
You make me feel like
that. Introducing the new Capital One Saver Card. Earn 4% cash back on dining and 4% on entertainment. Now when you go out, you cash in. What's in your wallet?
I am the DQ Chicken Strip Basket, and I have gone totally flavor crazy with not one, but two sauced and tossed baskets of 100% seasoned white meat tenderloin strips. Try spicy sweet glazed made with Frank's Red Hot for a touch of heat, or the smoky honey barbecue glazed. Either way, ranch me for maximum flavor craziness. Plus, fries and Texas toast in the DQ Chicken Strip Basket. Because I'm not fast food, I am fan food.
Well, the cadets in the building here in Charleston tonight for the Citadel and UNCG. Raucous atmosphere. Told you, final home game of the season for the Bulldogs. They will travel to VMI, a little military classic of the South. Rematch on Saturday. That's a SoCon game, one of four SoCon wins for the Bulldogs when the cadets were here in Charleston. It was won at the buzzer. Quaison Williams, the game-winning basket at the horn in that one. And Lou Stallworth looking to blow by Pat, blow by Massey,
good
kicks
luck.
It out to Brown. And he couldn't knock down the three, but that's, like you said, Jansen, a clean look that the Bulldogs will take. And out of control is Dickey, another offensive foul.
I think they'll call the walk before the offensive foul. Quick play, Hayden Brown took that one right to the chest. See here, picks the ball up. Yep, definitely a travel before. Also, definitely an offensive foul, but got called for the travel right before it. A full court pressure here from the Spartans. Now they're going to back off. Lou Stallworth brings it up himself.
Quick first step. You see, it's hard to stay with that guy. 13 and white for the Citadel. Kern's going to let it go again. And another one. Seven made threes
Connor
for Connor Kern.
He's on fire. Another one for Spartans.
How about the answer from Malik Massey? You got to give the UNCG Spartans some credit that every time the Bulldogs look as if they might pull away, they've had an answer. And Stallworth draw some contact at the rim.
Yeah, like you were saying, Connor, they've got an answer every time. Connor Curran's hit now seven from deep. One of the Spartans comes right back and hits one to counter. You see here the drive from Moose Stallworth. Again, making contact with the left side of his body and finishing far out to his right hand. Just has a way to make contact and still maintain his path to the basket.
And he makes the first. Moose Stallworth, told you, filled right in for Frankie Johnson after he transferred a season ago. It was really good pickup in the offseason. Jerry Higgins will get some time as well, who just checked into the ball game. Little full court pressure. 1-2-2 look from the Bulldogs.
We'll see back to the 3-2. Going to have to guard this high post and then watch underneath. It's a one-on-one.
Dickey gets it back off the tip back. Second chance, yes, for Caleb Hunter.
Be tough. Hayden Brown going to the floor there, looking for the offensive foul. It's going to be hard. These post players, they really like to make contact. The refs are going to let them play.
Lou Stallworth tied for second in scoring, 20 points per contest. Gets to the cup, and Dickey swats this one away. And James Dickey, one of the top shot blockers in the Southern Conference, shows why right there.
Dickey's got a great ability to read where his teammate is going to be. You're going to see here that he goes up and over both his teammate and Lou Stallworth, reads it perfectly, and gets it at the peak of the shot.
And a whistle underneath the baskets against the Spartans. Each team with 16 fouls. Bulldogs had the opening four fouls of the half. Light to go to Najdawi off the inbounds. He's a reliable 6'7" forwards, especially when you're lobbing it over the top like that. Kern, his first miss of the half, and the Bulldogs get it back. Stallworth attacks glass. Stick back, Kern is there again.
Hustle points for Zane Najdawi, and then points for Connor Kern there, crashing the boards. Siddle doesn't usually send many crashers, but when they do, they get a second chance.
Galloway the turnaround.
Once again, the Spartans just able to counter. Whatever the Citadel does, they come right back and score. It's going to be a game of runs here for both teams, it looks like, tonight.
A little over a minute to go, first half here in McAllister Fieldhouse.
Double screen up top to try and get the switch.
Good
underneath.
Back cut from Najdawi, and he lays it home.
Very well drawn up play, a double screen. Fake for the shooter, and then a roll by Najdawi. A good back pass, backdoor pass by Lou Stallworth to find his big man cutting to the hole.
50-47 with 1 minute to play in the first half and a timeout on the floor. Well, this is how the Bulldogs were playing earlier in the year. Started 9-2. We told you 12-15, so you see it 3-13 over those last 18 contests. And this team tonight has come to play and are challenging a UNCG team that is 61st in the net rankings right now, and a team that on a lot of bracketologists' radars, if you will, this time of the year about a possible at-large bid. This is a SoCon that could receive two bids. Wofford's right now in the top 25. They're 24th in the nation. Just cracked the AP poll this week in 19th in net. Top four teams in this conference, as good as any league you'll find, with Wofford's, Furman, UNCG, and ETSU. Asheville gonna be fun next week.
Bulldogs moving well on defense.
Massey, the fadeaway. It's off target. Stick back, yes. Kyron Galloway, the junior from Milton, Georgia. He's been big for the Spartans the last couple minutes.
Yeah, Galloway able to sky up and snag that rebound and put it right back up with one bounce. Bulldogs are playing more comfortable and more confident than we've seen in quite some time. Spartans send a double.
Here's the trap and Kern looking for space. Shot clock's at 2, game clock at 5. Stallworth has to launch. 1 second, and that one's gonna be short. A 50-49 first half. Efficient shooting from both teams. Get a 1-point game. As good as it gets late in the Southern Conference season, final regular season week of Southern Conference play in the second meeting between these two teams, all UNCG when they met at the Coliseum. You go back a little over a month ago on January 24th, UNCG a commanding win at home, 83-60 in that one. And the Bulldogs will be in the home whites with the navy blue letters and numbers. UNCG in the navy blues with gold trim. And Kern carries over the momentum to start the second half.
The initial play was for Matt Frierson, but now they leave Alonzo in the corner.
This one spins in and out. Hayden Brown lobs it underneath. Good find and nice Tawi. And Hayden Brown looks like a point guard there.
Yeah, and you see here, just in transition, Lou Stallworth is looking for all his options. He created that with his eyes up the entire time. UNCG now playing from behind.
And this one's intercepted. Kern in transition will pull up for 3. He's feeling it. Connects again.
That's tough for a player to pull up in transition like that. That shows confidence. Connor Kern keeping it real tonight.
Alonzo trying to bank it off glass. Couldn't get it to go.
Good box out from Najdawi. Just made enough contact to not allow Dickey to get that second chance rebound. Citadel now competitive on the rebounding charts.
Stallworth trying to get downhill. Attacks glass and he finishes. And Wes Miller wants to call a timeout. A 10-0 run to start the second half. And the largest lead of the game. We'll take a break on ESPN Plus. We'll come back to you with more SoCon basketball.
Are the moments that move you. Roper St. Francis Orthopedics is South Carolina's leader when it comes to letting you stay in play. Our top-rated program has over 30 specialists across the Lowcountry who are ready to treat all of your moving parts. Call 727-DOCS to keep on moving.
East Bay Deli is a New York-style deli with a distinctive Southern flair. Our eclectic menu is fresh, delicious, and affordable. Enjoy our fresh salad bar, large sandwiches featuring certified Angus beef, delicious and healthy wraps, and our selection of gluten-free options. Come in for our signature sandwich, the Citadel. Our Carnegie Deli cheesecake will take you straight to New York City. See why we've been voted best deli for over a decade at East Bay Deli.
9 is score, 11 point Citadel leads over UNCG. Just a minute and a half into play, and Connor Kern carries the spark plug in the second half. This guy tonight, 10 made threes. Really getting it done from downtown and showing off that quick release tonight.
A 10-0 run coming out of the locker room for the Bulldogs. Spartans going to look to end that here. Galonzo getting stripped yet again. Hasn't been able to get too much going early on here in the second half.
Stallworth up and under. How sweet was that for the grad transfer? This one off the fingertips of Galloway.
So the thing that's standing out right now for the Bulldogs is with Lou Stallworth, his earlier drives were shut down by the Spartan defense. Now with three guys flirting with a double-double, Connor Kern flirting with 30 points, it's more threats outside. Lou Stallworth, that drive starting to open up.
Kern looking for space again. Bullets one to Brown. He couldn't get the reverse to go. In transition comes Miller. The kick out, Alonzo. Good shot fake. And he draws the blocking foul against Connor Kern.
Just there, a half second too late. Hayden Brown did a good job forcing him baseline. Connor Kern looked like he was still in the sliding motion. Referee standing right there calls the blocking foul.
This is a split second late. There. Either way, he's played phenomenal tonight. Demetrius Troy's the trigger man. It's been a little bit quiet for UNCG. Finds Dickey, and he's trapped. A jump ball call. The possession arrow will stay with the Spartans.
Spartans have just a little down look on their faces. Wes Miller trying to get them to look up a little bit more. They've got the talent. Their point guard here, Miller, had been slicing and dicing earlier in the game.
Alonzo will tee it up. And the Bulldogs come away with it. The lead continues to grow. 13's the largest. Can the Bulldogs continue to increase? Shot selection has been exceptional for the Citadel tonight. So important for teams that want to get up and down. Nash Dowie says, I want to get a part of the action as well. And he connects from three.
Showing just how many weapons the Bulldogs have. Najdawi's been quiet with 4 points, knocking one down there from deep. Troy's open.
Timely three from Demetrius Troy, the senior from Raleigh. Good tap back, Kern again. Little heat check. Shot fake for Troy. Galloway had the offensive board, and then it was taken away. And Lou Stallworth says, let's slow it up. 13 and White right here. One of the top floor generals in the Southern Conference. 20 points per. Najdawi again. That's two in a row for the big fella.
Immediately knew he was going to shoot that. No hesitation. Caught the ball. Went straight into his shooting motion. One of the more dangerous shooters from a big man standpoint. Has a Dirk Nowitzki type shot. Shoots at the top of his shot.
Galloway silences the crowd momentarily.
Speaking of big man who can shoot, Galloway proving he's a threat from the corner as well. See the skip here to Lou Stallworth to break the press. Bulldogs doing a great job moving the ball. Lou Stallworth making contact first.
Big rebound by Dickey. Miller, the sophomore. They dump it to Dickey. Trying to go to work over Najdawi and bullies his way for two.
Yeah, you see a little bit of help there from Matt Frierson trying to get a hand in, but nothing solid. Left Najdawi one-on-one. We've seen it's more of a disadvantage with that size factor. Coach Bacham calling for more rotation, getting these guys to move. They've done a great job finding open spaces.
Frierson, one bounce and a three. It is raining threes here in Charleston. 14-point Bulldogs lead, 71-57. We'll be right back with more SoCon Hoops on the other side of the break.
You should be mad at leaf blowers. You should be mad your neighbor always wants to hang out.
Guess what? I got a new grill.
And you should be mad your smart fridge is unnecessarily complicated.
Make ice.
But you're not mad because you have E-Trade, which isn't complicated. Their tools make trading quicker and simpler so you can take on the markets with confidence. Don't get mad. Get E-Trade and start trading today.
MLS is back. It's time for our soccer. DC United versus Atlanta United, followed by LAFC versus Sporting KC, Sunday on ESPN.
You're gonna make me turn back, way back to the oldest me. Guarantee that you notice me. You don't walk on my soul for free. You're gonna make me turn back, way back to the oldest me. Guarantee that you notice me.
Get four lines of unlimited data for $100 a month at Cricket. Ooh, someone's having a good hair day. Smile, you're on Cricket.
Well, you hear us mention the net rankings, and you have four Southern Conference teams in the top 66 in net. Take a look at that. Wofford, a top 25 nationally ranked team. They're 19th in net, 24th in the AP poll after taking down Furman in Greenville on Saturday night. This UNCG team on many different bracketologist radars, as we told you, as a possible at-large bid. 24 wins right now, and you're 61st in net. We mentioned net. That's the NCAA's new evaluation tool. And the first year of the net ranking. So it'll be interesting to see on Selection Sunday, Jansen, how much weight that net actually holds by the committee.
Yeah, we'll see what the committee does decide. A lot of these statistics aren't used as heavily as they look. We've got a couple different polls, the NCAA team poll, the coaches poll, and now the net rankings. It's going to be interesting to see, like you said, what the committee chooses to do.
Wofford, perfect 16-0. In the Southern Conference, and a gauntlet of a Southern Conference. You would think that the Terriers should certainly be deserving of an at-large bid. You could argue any of the other three in the top four, barring that they don't win the SoCon tournament, and Reeds is able to swirl in a three.
Just a 1-2 back and forth from Najdawi in the post. Able to kick it back out to Alex Reed.
Good block from Najdawi. It is all Bulldogs. Allegri sets his feet. And there's life for UNCG. Plenty of time here in the second half.
That's the second time now that the freshman has cut a Bulldog run short. Standing out from the crowd as a freshman able to pull up with those big shots. This has an impressive night so far.
Ball fake from Reed. Stallworth from downtown. And Massey collects the rebounds. Miller can get downhill. The floater. A little too strong off the glass. And out of bounds, it will remain with the Spartans. So big thing with the Citadel is they haven't been in a ton of these type of situations. Double-digit lead over a 24-win UNCG team. Can they close it out in the final 13 minutes? Consistency, the big thing the coach and staff for the Bulldogs want to stress. Big win on Saturday against Samford. Looking for two in a row.
Yeah, the Bulldogs have grinded out a couple close games down the stretch, but not really been up like this on another quality team yet. Now it's about maintaining down the stretch. We'll see if they can get some defensive stops here.
And Allegri is fouled shooting the three.
Crowd doesn't like it, but we saw quite a bit of contact here. Lou Stallworth gets Allegri on the arm here. If it alters the shot whatsoever, you see there just his left arm. He's a left-handed shooter. So Lou Stallworth coming from his strong shooting side making just a little bit of contact. Referee standing right there on the sideline to catch that one.
And Allegri wide on the first. Freshman forward cracked the rotation for Wes Miller's crew. And he misses the second. And for UNCG, you've got to capitalize. The Bulldogs have been on fire the entire night. UNCG, they've been in these situations before. We told you, NCAA tournament appearance a season ago. They won against ETSU in the SoCon championship game. They've been behind, and they force a turnover here. Allegri out in front of Najdawi. Bucket plus the foul.
Allegri well out in front of Najdawi there on the break. Hunter able to find him in transition. Lou Stallworth tried a unnatural over-the-head skip pass. Najdawi just with a foul. In that situation, I'm fouling a little bit harder than that and not making that one an easy one for the freshman Allegri, but now an and one and 3 points total.
Back to a single-digit lead for the Bulldogs. 74-66. Nearly a turnover again. The pressure bothering the Bulldogs. And Reed, the Euro. Najdawi, a monster offensive boards. And he sticks it back in. The and one for the senior.
A foul down on one end that converts for the freshman Allegri for an and one. Najdawi comes down the other end and does the same thing down low. Najdawi's been a little bit of a secret weapon here tonight. Not flashy points-wise, but able to knock him down when it counts. Again, crashing the boards. These little second-chance opportunities that the Citadel has been capitalizing has kept them now up 10 with a chance to go up 11.
Zane Najdawi at the charity stripe. He is automatic and completes the three-point play. There's Duger Balcom. This would be one of the bigger wins this year. You gotta keep in mind, this Citadel team was 9-2. I think you see the Bulldogs right before Christmas, you know that they're a team that could have contended with any of the top four. Haven't quite played as well. They went one at South Florida, at Campbell, at JMU. That's a nice road wins. Trying to take down a 24-win UNCG team that is still in the hunt for the at-large bubble picture. Troy knocks down the three.
At 24 wins for this Spartan program, ties the third most in school history. Trying to make that 25 here tonight. Bulldogs giving them a run for their money. I've been very impressed with the guard play of the Spartans. Miller up top, Malik Massey. They've done a good job on Lou Stallworth. Now it goes over to the big guys down low when he makes those drives.
Miller with numbers, pushes the pace, and finishes at the rim. It's a six-point game here in McAllister Fieldhouse. From 16 down, the Spartans have stormed back.
A quick swing from being down 11 to now 6. Bulldogs have to get back in the swing of things. Spartans doing a good job getting stops.
Ooh, sweet move for Stallworth. So good at the spin in the paint.
And again, that happens because the Spartans' defense is not able to collapse down low as much as they were before. As you see a foul there by Hayden Brown, Lou Stallworth knows there's threats around him.
79-71, we'll be right back after the timeout on ESPN Plus.
Try new Barbasol razors. We had long deployments in Iraq. Really grateful that USA was able to take care of my family while I was overseas serving.
It was my very first car accident. We were hit from behind. I called USAA, and the first thing they asked was, are you okay? They always thank you for your service, which is nice because as a spouse, you serve too.
We're the Hales, and we're USAA members for life.
See how much you could save with USAA by bundling your auto and home insurance. Get a quote today.
Try new Barbasol razors.
8 points in the lead here in McAllister Fieldhouse in Charleston. Momentum on UNCG's side, though. They were down 65-39 earlier in the second half. And it made things interesting here. Wes Miller's crew with just under 11 minutes to play, trying to make that push and get back in this thing.
We talked about earlier the advantage being with the Citadel having lots of guys flirting with double-doubles. Now they have four scores in that double-digit scoring column. But UNCG coming right behind, now three in the double-digit column. A spread scoring attack here from Greensboro late down the stretch.
Citadel's been vocal defensively as well. Inside, Dickey tips it out to Galloway. That was a clean look for the Spartans, and empty again for UNCG. Good look to Najdawi through the hands, and a turnover forcing a two-on-one. Miller drops it off, and Alonso sticks it in.
Bulldogs have got to convert on these passes and get the ball past half court, get away from this trap. Maintain the offensive presence that they were before. Lou Stallworth knows he's got the weapons around him. Connor Kern hasn't gotten off a shot in quite some time. Matt Frierson from one.
That was from deep. And a foul against the Citadel.
Yeah, Zane Najdawi just on the back of Dickey. Played that one well. Najdawi's going to sit now with four fouls total.
Thugger Balcom didn't like the call.
So it looks like UNCG is going to put pressure down low now. They've got two bigs. Allegri showing he's been a threat, a freshman with Dickey at the high post.
Miller sizing up Frierson. Shot fake for Alonso. And he cashes in. And a foul as Dickey was shoved to the floor after the made basket.
Their second big, Hayden Brown, a little too physical after the shot. We're fighting for position. Dickey looked like he might have been falling a little bit there. Hayden Brown had his arm on the shoulder, and that might have been what the referees saw. They're going to go to the monitor here.
And they'll take a look and see if this warrants anything more than a common foul. Officials coming over right now to talk to us.
Yep. So we'll see here. Hayden Brown just goes for the box out on Dickey. Ball goes up. Hayden Brown's right arm is just laying on Dickey's shoulder there.
And we'll see if this warrants anything more. As I mentioned, it's a common foul. Whether this would be a flagrant would be a big turning point for UNCG. Alonso was able to hit that three after getting his man in the air. Officials still at the table, checking this one out. We're at 9:27 on the game clock here in the second half.
In my opinion, didn't seem too much warranted for a flagrant. There's a lot of contact. They had a couple different angles over there on the secondary monitor. We'll see what they call. Referees have called quite a good game here tonight.
Three-point game. This is as close as it's been since we started the second half when it was Bulldogs by one. They went on a 10-0 run to start the second half here. Wes Miller wanted to call a timeout, talk about things. And we'll see now the official word is they give the coaches the explanation as well.
Leaguer 1, 33, unnecessary contact.
Yep. So it is a flagrant one on Hayden Brown of the Citadel. Unnecessary contact above the shoulder there. And so now this can really change the dynamic of the game here. Alonzo hits a three, and we have a flagrant. Now you see Duger Balcom looking to make it two in a row. It was a huge win here in Charleston on Saturday. James Dickey at the line with a raucous student section full of cadets.
The pressure's on here as the clock is winding down, now showing 9:27. Dickey's going to miss the second as well.
James Dickey, 47.5% free throw shooter with a tough environment, comes up empty. And the Spartans get the basketball back. Bulldogs dodge a bullet there.
Lots of movement. They're going to go to the mismatch. Lou Stallworth on the big center, Dickey.
And he capitalizes. That's a good find off the inbound there.
Yeah, and those tight baseline plays, if there's no communication, especially as you saw right there between the Bulldogs, there's going to find a mismatch. People are moving everywhere. You've got to be able to talk to your teammates and either switch on those screens or get through the contact. See there, just a mismatch coming up top with Lou Stallworth and Dickey.
You talk about the 27 wins a season ago as Reeds lets it fly. Probably not the shot the Bulldogs were looking for there. Alonzo to retake the lead, and he hits.
They've left him open one too many times, finding him in the corner in transition. Alonzo runs straight to the corner. They have not seemed to figure that one out yet. Still open for yet another three. Number 10, Alonzo.
We've got a timeout on the floor. So UNCG, we figured they would. 24-win team has stormed back to take a two-point lead. This is a game that the Citadel had complete control of as we started the second half. We'll take a break as well on ESPN Plus. Southern Conference basketball will continue right after this.
Coors Light is cold filtered for brightness and clarity. The world's most refreshing beer, Coors Light.
MLS is back. It's our soccer. Sunday on ESPN.
You're gonna make me turn back, way back to the oldest me. Guarantee that you notice me. You don't walk on my soul from sleep. You're gonna make me turn back.
I've got to tell you something important. It's not going to be easy. Quicksilver earns you unlimited 1.5% cash back on every purchase everywhere. Actually, that's super easy. My bad.
I am the DQ chicken strip basket, and I have gone totally flavor crazy with not one, but two sauced and tossed baskets of 100% seasoned white meat tenderloin strips. Try spicy sweet glazed made with Frank's Red Hot for a touch of heat, or the smoky honey barbecue glazed. Either way, ranch me for maximum flavor craziness, plus fries and Texas toast in the DQ chicken strip basket. Because I'm not fast food, I am fan food.
Two-point UNCG leads. They led by 16 at 65-49 earlier in the second half. Wes Miller's crew, 27 wins a season ago. That is the third most in single-season program history. Good spin from Stallworth. Finishes plus the buckets.
Malik Massey played pretty good defense on Lou Stallworth. Lou Stallworth just had the downhill momentum and still finished a little bit above Massey for that shot. Again, just the finishing ability of 1-3 for the Bulldogs, showing yet again impressive here in clutch time, putting them tied 81.
Well, he's going to have to take over for the Bulldogs to have an opportunity here. He's got a quiet 15 points, only 5 of 13 shooting. This is a guy that's a 20-point scorer. And the cadets starting to get loud here in McAllister, and an offensive foul against Francis Alonzo.
The Bulldog players had mentioned it to the refs that he was moving before the play even began. They're getting caught on the moving screen. Opportunity here for the Bulldogs to take one more step out in front.
Our officiating crew, Zelton Steeds, Landon Brands, and Chris Fords. Connor Kern can't leave him alone tonight. The kick out reads. And off the side of the rim, there's a foul against the Spartans.
Najdowi getting hung up there underneath. Alex Reed had the shot. Long rebound down low. Massey just had a little bit too much contact. Tough there when players get hooked up underneath.
And they're going to take a look at this one to see if it warrants anything further than a common foul.
The tough thing with these fouls is when the players are falling to the ground and contact's already been made, a lot of the times those forearms might look intentional. You don't know whether or not they were throwing downward or their arm was just still there maintaining contact with the player. It's tough, especially for an undermatched guard like Massey on the bigger Najdowi fighting for position.
Well, replay certainly changed the landscape of college basketball a little bit, the ability to take a look at certain things. Again, you want to get it right. Been a lot of talk, though, across college basketball as to whether or not is there a way to maybe speed things up at the table. Maybe they put a two-minute clock on there where if you can't decide by that point, the call stands.
Right, yeah, it's tough, especially when those small details come into play of whether or not you already have a team advantage in fouls. A lot of outside circumstances come into play. It looks like they're going to handle this replay fairly quickly.
So we'll get another explanation now. So it's a common foul against UNCG, nothing further. Again, we had the flagrant one on Hayden Brown earlier for the Citadel. Good basketball game here in Charleston.
Connor Kern hasn't gotten a shot up lately, neither has Matt Frierson. Alex Reed has taken the last couple three-pointers off the mark. We'll see if the Bulldogs start to change up a little bit or go back to Lou Stallworth. Kendall, you mentioned he probably needs to start putting it on his shoulders here.
Euro step from Najdowi. A little too strong. Isaiah Miller wants to push the pace. Troy, no. Galloway is there. And this one just hung on the rim and fell off.
Good tip off backwards by Alex Reed.
Stalwart trying to scoop it off the glass. And they say UNCG basketball.
That's tough. Again, the Citadel just didn't have very many bodies at the rim. There's about four blue jerseys and only Naj Dowie down low. Nobody else crashed the boards. It's a tough situation, and advantage goes to the Spartans for that rebound.
Troy will pull it again. Misfires from three. Reed down the alley. Matt Frierson, 11 points tonight. He's in double figures as well. Naj Dowie will line it up. And Galloway collects the boards.
That was tough. Had the long outstretched arms of Dickey running at him for that shot. Now they go one on one down low.
And Naj Dowie poked it loose from Dickey. Here comes Stallworth. He had the shot altered. And Alonzo the rebound. Miller, extra pass. Galloway for three. Bang. Big time three for the Spartans.
Just like that, Spartans go up 84-82. A lot of contact here. Referees made a no call. Spartans capitalized. Bulldogs looking a little stagnant here on offense, not as comfortable as they were in the beginning of the game.
Connor Curran thought about it. Frierson with two on the shot clock. And out of bounds will stay with the Bulldogs of the Citadel.
Naj Dowie showing that senior heart of his, really going to work on the boards. Hustling extremely hard to get these second chance opportunities for the Bulldogs. Trying to capitalize, they haven't quite yet.
No, the Citadel, Lou Stallworth gonna trigger it in. Who do you look for on this possession, Hayden, if you're the Citadel down two?
Yeah, we're just going to look for to move the ball and try to get a kick out like they just did there.
And Higgins could knock it down. Connor Kern tonight, 10 of 13, 9 of 12 from three. With 29 points for the Bulldogs.
For the middle, Kern's open.
And he connects again. Make it 32 for the...
Now they've got to get back on defense and get a stop here. It's vital. Clock now under 5 minutes. Spartans didn't look to push in transition. Set it up in the half court now.
Citadel by one. Miller trying to make this move against Higgins. He poked it loose. Miller got it back. Dickey shuffled the feet, but it's an offensive foul.
Hayden Brown stepped in front of Miller. Momentum still carrying him downwards. The pass looked like it might have gotten off. Referee calls it first. Miller puts his head down, goes right into Hayden Brown, jumped up in the air, tried to get around the contact. Referee thought there was, made the call.
Well, Hayden Brown, really good sophomore for the Citadel. Does all the little things for this team. Missed a handful of games right after Christmas due to injury. And has reinserted himself in the starting five as a blocking foul is issued to Francis Alonzo. And you gotta be careful here. Alonzo didn't like the call. He just picked up his third.
Citadel has got to watch those traps in the corner when they're pushing it up. Jerry Higgins got away. A trap was coming there. Blocking foul. Now to come, it might have been another situation.
Caleb Harris. Extra pass to Kern. Stallworth again. It's off the mark.
Miller again in transition. He's been threatening there all Knight again there. Kalen Harris gets a little arm on the waist of Miller.
Yeah, good transition defense that time by the Bulldogs to get back. Miller, one of those guards that he can beat you in transition, has a quick first step. But on top of that, the Bulldogs were able to seal him off, and he'll head to the charity stripe for UNCG. Isaiah Miller, only a 55% free throw shooter. UNCG checks into this contest 70% from the charity stripe. There are a few holes, though, when you look in within their lineup. James Dickey struggles at the line. Isaiah Miller struggles at the line. A couple things that could affect the Spartans in the conference tournament, possibly, if they don't clean it up. And they are now 4 of 9 from the charity stripe in this one tonight.
We'll see what the Bulldogs do here if they push it and try to get some fast break points on the move. Looks like it may be a half-court set here. They've got to break the pressure first.
One-point Spartans lead. Dangerous pass there. Stallworth was able to get it just in front of an outstretched James Dickey. Stallworth the kick out. That's their shooter. Frierson hits from deep.
All started from the drive of Lou Stallworth. Made the defense collapse. Had his weapons outside. Matt Frierson hits one. That's an important one right there.
Galloway all alone, a little breakdown defensively for the Bulldogs.
Again, we've talked about it. They have continuously had a counter shot every time the Bulldogs hit a big one. Right there, a defensive slip and another turnover.
Takeaway by Miller. Downhill, scoops it off glass and gets the bounce.
Bulldogs have a chance here in this half-court set to make something happen and keep it alive. UNCG, if they hit one more of those big shots, momentum heavily leans in their direction. See if Matt Frierson or one of these other shooters, Connor Kern, again, hasn't attempted one lately.
Reed, extra pass, Kern. He thought he was fouled. No whistle.
Alonzo Francis calling to slow it down. Going to need some pressure here from the Bulldog defense to get a stop.
Under 2.5 to play. Massey, the junior from Charlotte, North Carolina, handles the rock. They go to their senior, Alonzo. Bulldogs in a man-to-man look defensively, and a foul against Matt Frierson.
That's a tough defensive assignment for Matt Frierson, not known for his straight-up speed. Matched up for an isolation defense on the quickest player on UNCG.
We'll take a break. It's 91-88. Can the Bulldogs make a last push, or can UNCG hang on?
MLS is back. It's time for our soccer. DC United versus Atlanta United, followed by LAFC versus Sporting KC, Sunday on ESPN.
On March 8th.
I got file on you.
What's it say? Big imagination, plays well with others.
That's what I'm talking about.
Captain Marvel, rated PG-13. Everywhere, March 8th.
One Venture card, you'll earn unlimited double miles on every purchase every day, not just airline purchases. Think about all the double miles you could be earning.
Holy moly, that's a lot of miles!
Shh. What's in your wallet? Shh.
Guarantee that you notice me. You don't walk on my soul for free. You're gonna make me turn.
UNCG by three with just over 2 minutes to play here in Charleston, South Carolina. Kendall Lewis and Jansen Brown. What a fun one we've had here tonight, partner. And at the line is Isaiah Miller. It's been a hard-fought game for both teams.
It's a close contest, and as a basketball fan, you can't ask for more games like this. It's been extremely entertaining, both sides. Really putting their all into this game, closing out Southern Conference matchups.
So Miller, we told you, struggles at the free throw line. Makes it a two possession game. 18 fouls against the Citadel, 6 against UNCG.
What the Bulldogs go to here. I'm sure they'll look for their shooters, especially if Lou Stallworth can get a drive and again collapse that defense. In this 2-3 zone, though, the way to break it, and any coach will tell you, you have to attack the gaps. Make the players collapse inside and look for a kick out. They've got shooters that have made a shot. Matt Frierson open.
And he hits again.
That's just miscommunication on the Spartan defense. Matt Frierson went corner to corner, ran the baseline. Nobody pointed him out. Wide open in the corner. Big shot for the senior.
1:32 to play. Troy trying to lob it to his high school teammate, Dickey, who goes up and gets it, and he was fouled. Those two played together at Word of God in Raleigh, North Carolina. And Troy really threaded the needle that time.
See Lou Stallworth went vied for the switch instead of staying home up top, allowed Dickey to get over him. The lob is going to be there all night for the much larger and longer Dickey down low.
And Dickey couldn't convert. Door is open for the Bulldogs.
UNCG shooting 53% from the free throw line. Bulldogs shooting 83. Down the stretch, these are where they count.
And one of two. 3-point game with a minute 27.
Skip to Lou Stallworth, and we'll see where they go now. Should be a high flash here going from Zane Najdawi.
Najdawi will line it up. That was for the tie. And Miller collects again.
Again, no crashers for the Bulldogs. Couple of the guards on the right side. It was a long rebound.
Galloway from the corner. And a foul against Najdawi.
Referee was standing right beside the shooter. Didn't look like any initial contact on the way up. Might have been on the way down, not allowing Galloway to land. We'll see here, just a bullet pass to the corner. Galloway might have sold that one a little bit. Had some contact down low at the feet, but tough call here with 50 seconds on the clock. Could be a deciding factor.
So now you get Tyree Galloway, 69% free throw shooter that hits the first. Still plenty of time.
Bulldogs gonna have to score fast. May opt for a quick foul depending on who gets the inbound pass after a quick score.
Galloway got three there. I'm not sure his toes were behind the line there, but either way, he makes two of three. And Stallworth attacking glass, got it to go, and they waved the shot off.
blew his whistle long before Lou Stallworth got the shot up. Crowd may not have heard it. Saw the ball go down and came alive a little bit here, but Stallworth called on the ground. 1-1 here for the Bulldogs.
These are big for the grad transfer. Cash money on the first. He's a 74% free throw shooter. Exactly what a coach wants. A floor general, not scared to distribute the basketball when he doesn't have a shot, but has the ability to score. His game reminds me so much, Jansen, of a guy like Russell Westbrook. He can get to the rim. Stallworth, he's a guy that even when you think he's not scoring, you look down at the box score and he's still able to get in double figures night in and night out.
Definitely. Now subbing in Derek Webster here for a little bit more defense. Sitting Matt Frierson. Galloway's open to get the steal.
Stallworth to take away. And he lays it home. 40 seconds left. And a timeout here in McAllister Fieldhouse.
You see here the inbound. He looked for Galloway, then passed it to his right. Lonzo looked like he was falling on the initial catch. Stallworth able to get up to the hoop, finished with his left hand. Bulldogs down one with, like you said, plenty of time. The last time we looked at the clock, it was 51 seconds with Galloway at the free throw line. Minimal time has run off. Citadel now down one.
Well, this has been one of the things that Duggar and staff, they've wanted to challenge this Citadel team. Second half of the season, can they piece together back-to-back wins? They are looking for 2-0, two in a row, and UNCG looking for their third straight win. Spartans 24 on the year, 13 Southern Conference victories. And again, trying to be among the elite status, if you can piece together back-to-back to back 25 win seasons, would be three in a row for Wes Miller's crew.
And obviously, if we're speaking with overall record, UNC Greensboro has quite a bit to lose here if they go down to the Citadel. Going to have to rope it in here on the inbound and get a quality look. Citadel's going to have to be careful not to foul one of their better shooters. Galloway has knocked down some clutch ones here late. I think they might go deep for a Dickey or a quick screen here for Alonzo or Miller on the right side.
Pressure by the Bulldogs as Alonzo gets it to Miller. 2-on-1. This one tapped away by Brown, and then he's called for the foul. If you're Duggar Balcom, you'll take that one right now.
Yeah, you'll take it. He got the deflection, played that very well. Coaches try to practice that as much as they can in practice. 2-on-1 uneven situations. Hayden Brown stutter stepped at Miller, was able to get the deflection. Now Dickey at the foul line.
And that's a great foul because Dickey's only a 45% free throw shooter.
It
is. This is kind of what we were talking about with UNCG. There are some liabilities, if you will. They shoot 70% as a team for the charity stripe, but there's some liabilities within the lineup, especially late game. And Dickey, with a raucous crowd, makes the first.
Yeah, and on his other free throws thus far in the game, he's been short. He looked like he put a little bit more underneath that one. We'll see if he gets this one to go to make it a three-point game.
This is one that Wes Miller's crew has to have to maintain that at-large bubble picture. I think most would agree. And he gets it to go.
Big free throw for Dickey to knock that one down. Makes it a three-point game.
So if you're Bulldogs, what do you draw up here?
I think it's a quick score. If clock's still running down this fast, don't necessarily have to get a three, but now with clock only at 20 seconds, you're going to have to go for one.
Stallworth down the alley. Too many steps. He traveled.
And he's unfortunately done that a few times this year down the stretch where he gets in the lane and picks up his dribble or gets it stripped away. You see here, he crosses over, goes to his left, goes for the spin, but when he jumps there, he lifts his left pivot foot up, tries to get a shot off, but pivot had already left the ground. And Lou Stallworth with a turnover.
Yeah, tough shot for Francis Alonso as well.
You have to play this close. It looks like they're going to do the same situation. Miller comes across for a double screen, and he's open.
Galloway's fouled. 69% free throw shooter. And again, if you're the Bulldogs, they did exactly what they needed to do. They had Alonso covered there. He's their top free throw shooter at 88%. So Galloway will go to the line, and that is team foul number 10 against the Bulldogs. So two for Galloway. Now, interesting scenario could come into play here, and it's probably one of the more controversial in college basketball. 13 and a half seconds remaining. If Galloway misses this and you're UNCG, do you foul the Citadel? They only get two shots. You have a three-point lead. Now it's out of play.
Not going to happen with that one. Makes it a two-possession game. Citadel has to score quickly.
And Stallworth downhill. He was fouled. 1-1 for Stallworth. That's the seventh against the Spartans.
So another controversial situation could come up here. Kendall, what would you do as we see here? Lou Stallworth just goes full steam ahead down the court. But if we make this first one, does he miss the second one intentionally to try to get a rebound and a foul? Or does he knock it down and potentially send a shooter like Galloway or Alonso back to the line and spread the lead just a little bit more?
That's a great question, and certainly one that's debated between coaches as well. As we told you, the under 10, do you foul? It'd be interesting to see what Stallworth does here, because 8.8 seconds doesn't leave you. You're right, Jansen, a lot of time they come down, make free throws, game is over. And he missed it, but Alonso secured the rebound.
Only one rebounder there, Alex Reed. Again, a downside to the Citadel, not sending too many people crashing. Now, that might have been an exemption. Lou Stallworth, the shooter, went to the right side, rebound went to the left, and now Spartans with a chance to possibly put this one away with single-digit seconds on the clock.
Alonso is one of the better free throw shooters in the SoCon. I think the Bulldogs know it as well. Not the guy they wanted to foul. He missed the first. Well, that scenario could come into play again.
Three-point
lead with under 10. I personally think you have to foul with a three-point lead under 10. We'll see if Alonso misses this, what Wes Miller does. And back to four. Stallworth just launches. That one stuck in between the glass and the rim, and the time expires. 100-96, the final score. UNCG wins this one in Charleston. A come-from-behind victory. They were down 16 points early in the second half. This has been a presentation of ESPN to view this game.